Hello, Owen Turtenwald here. I'm going to play a modern league with blue-green Infect. This is the deck I intend to play at Grand Prix Los Angeles. And if you're watching this, that tournament has concluded. Hopefully I won. Right, let's rock and roll. Or not. Pretty good hand for me. On the draw. Opponent takes a mulligan, I like that. Mutavault into Aether Vial. This looks like Merfolk to me. Don't think there's any chance of me not just playing Glistener Elf turn one. I can save the Cataxian Probe for next turn. I guess if I drew into a Hierarch, I would just play it. So let's go ahead and probe here. What in the world? Slivers? Okay. We have a Mana Weft, a Blur, a Dark Heart, and a Verdant Catacombs. Okay. So it's unlikely Apostle's Blessing can give protection from a color in this game because Mutavault is colorless and Blur Sliver is red. But it also doesn't look like that's going to matter much. Maybe this is bad to take 3 damage, but I want to be able to play an Inkmouth Nexus next turn if I were to draw a Blighted Agent. So. Surely he will just cast Mana Weft Sliver. There it is. If I draw a fetch land, I'm gonna try to go for the win here. Probe. That's just as good. The thing is, right now I can go Might of Old Crow, so Might Glistener Elf. Apostle's Blessing, give it protection from green, attack for 5. And at that point, Apostle's Blessing and Might of Old Crow, so will have been added to my graveyard. That's 4 cards, probe is 5. And with 3 lands, I can go activate Nexus, become immense it. It doesn't look like there's any chance he's going to have a flying creature. I guess I might as well, because if he was able to Aether Vial in a creature that was not green, he could block, or if he has a flying creature next turn. I mean, I think I'm overwhelming favorite to win anyway, so I might as well just look. Another probe. Doesn't look like there's much reason to cast that. Yeah, I mean, I don't think I should cast it. I mean, I'll just do it next turn, right? Might have old Crotia. And I'll play this thing. I will name green. So even if he draws a land, he plays a Blur Sliver, files in a Dark Heart Sliver, he can attack for 5, I'm at 11. Seems like I'll be fine. He has a Blur, a Dark Heart, and a Sedge. For him to win, he would need to draw like a Ghost Quarter or a Lightning Bolt or a Path to Exile. As far as I remember, given the cards I've seen and what I've seen out of these Slivers decks in the past, he probably only has Abrupt Decay as removal. So next turn with my Nexus, I'm going to be fine. It would be brutal if he had something like a Spinneret Sliver to give reach. That would be sad for me. I'm just going to probe him anyways, and so I won't go for the kill if he has anything, but there's got to be almost no cards that he can even have drawn that would make him have a chance to win. Yeah, I mean, he can cast a Blur, file in Dark Heart, attack for 4, lose. With the Vial on 2, he doesn't have very many. Oh, yeah, he drew Cavern of Souls. Unless I foolishly forgot that that was one of the cards in his hand. No, it was. That was weird. When the Cavern of Souls came into play, as he was naming, I looked at his cards in hand and it said 4, but then after he had named, it said 3. So it just didn't reflect the proper number of cards in hand because the cavern was naming. I was like, oh, did I miscount? No, I did not miscount. I'm happy with my play this game. Given the cards that I saw, there really isn't any other combination of ways I could have played it to even have a chance to win on the third turn, and I'm going to. And if I had failed to win by the third turn, it looks like he has enough stuff going on that would have been bad for me. Like, he might have been able to just race. I think that's a reasonable play to leave himself with a red and a green creature back so that another Apostle's Blessing won't give my creature protection from all of his creatures. So. Well, Slivers is a new one for me, I'll be honest. I know that that deck usually plays Collected Company. But I also think that the removal is probably Abrupt Decay. And given that his deck has Aether Vial and Collected Company, if he was to put a disruptive card in his sideboard, it would probably be a creature, like Spellskite. So, how do I sideboard against Spellskite? Certainly I want those. I don't think I want these. It's actually super common to just be sideboarding out one Glistener Elf when you're on the draw against decks that have, like, tons of creatures. Sort of want these Nature's Claims. The floor is... it's dead completely. Or I just kill Aether Vial. I guess if he has Aether Vial and Spellskite, it's probably worth it. Could just go for only one. Maybe it's bad to have my Twisted Images. They're really slow in matchups where I'm just straight goldfishing. But I do suspect that that deck would have Spellskite in it. Alright, I'll take out one Mutagenic Growth, and I'll have both my Nature's Claims. I diluted my deck pretty badly here, having, like, Nature's Claims and Twisted Images that could do nothing. I guess the Dismember still has some use, and that's the only amount of disruptive elements that I have. Well, this is a very good hand. Another mulligan. That's good for me. I almost couldn't tell that he had mulliganed because I looked at his number of cards in library and it just said like 56. I just got thrown off because he's playing a 61 card deck. At least my brain has been trained to when an opponent keeps, you just see 7 and 53 and it makes sense in your mind, but... alright, we'll see what happens with this Twisted Image. Looks like it's going to be at least reasonable. The biggest downside of my hand is that I have no pump spells, but if I draw a Become Immense, I'll win easily, and if I draw a Might of Old Krosa or a Vines of Vastwood, I'm going to win in two turns, because all I have to, with the Exalted from the Noble Hierarch, I hit once, and then the next turn I hit again. It's going to work out well. To be honest, I don't know which Slivers I would or would not dismember next turn. I'm going to use my dismember pretty flippantly because I know that I can just Twisted Image of Spellskite if one of those were to come out. Could just dismember now. I'm gonna wait because you never know, like, if he has another creature like a sinew sliver, he's going to play it before combat. If he has like a blur sliver, he might play that. I'd rather just try to get a little bit more information before committing to casting Dismember on something. Of course, that leads to the potential of me getting blown out, but yeah, I'm willing to take a risk for a marginal upside. Sure. Four life's a bit rough, but that thing's going to do more than four damage in the long run, so might as well do it. Aether Vial. Okay, well, there's a good chance my opponent just loses the game. Bladed Agent. Okay, if I Twisted Image, I hit for two. Thing is, I could Twisted Image now to try to draw into removal. Pump Spell. Which almost certainly would win the game, if I hit. But if I miss, and then he plays a Spellskite, I'm pretty screwed. Odds of my opponent having Spellskite are extremely low. Odds of my opponent casting Collected Company are not terribly low. I guess I don't win next turn. Do I? I hit for two. Oh yeah, I do. But it's going to be complicated. I have to play all my cards. Which is actually not that bad. What the... Like, next turn, if I hit for two with the Exalted, he's going to go to two poison. Then, if I play my Inkmoth Nexus and my Blighted Agent, I activate both my Nexuses, attack with two Nexuses, two Agents. That's four, and then both my Mutagenic Growths is eight. I think for that reason, it's clear what I should do now. And I'm actually going to cast this Mutagenic Growth for mana. That way I don't have to pay two life later. So I got him for four this turn. Next turn I have the remaining six that I need. I have a little bit of insurance against the Collected Company into Spellskite, or just a Spellskite. And if somehow he has removal or some kind of crazy turn where he attacks for a million, this way, I at least didn't lose two life for the Mutagenic Growth, so if the game were to prolong for another turn, I saved two damage. No clue if that's optimal, but I did it. That's so weird, he just didn't plus his Aether Vial. Oh, he did. Duh. Alright, well, let's just do this. It doesn't matter. I'm just gonna draw a card. Yeah, I mean, seems like I have no choice but to just go for the kill here. I'm not even dead on the crackback, because I'm going to lose two life to nine. Oh, flying, sick. Gale Rider Sliver. I did not consider that. Well, I would go to one if he didn't block and then attacked with everything on. I mean, if he didn't block, he would just lose, but. He's gonna double block. Alright. So if I let damage resolve, he goes to 6. I have lethal next turn. He attacks me for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think I think that one's easy. I do lose to a Blur Sliver. Oh, no, I don't, because he has to activate both his Mutavaults. I would lose to a Predatory or a Sinew Sliver. If he had a Muscle Sliver off Aether Vial, I would lose. But as it stands, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Can't even cast a Blur Sliver. I did give myself the best chance to win. I used my Twisted Image in an effort to try to draw into another pump spell, which would have been more reliable. Was this a Sedge? Blur. Okay, so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I got a 2. I win. All right, that'll do it.